Hey guys, it's the Ohio Fisherman. I'm fishing at this little pond that I'm always at. As you noticed, you might have noticed the weeds are gone, starting to die. There's a bunch of leaves on the top of the water though, probably 50 degrees. I'm throwing crankbaits right now with my bait caster and pretty much just cast it over there and reeled it in pretty slow. And I felt a little tap, so I just set the hook. I caught this about maybe 16-inch bass, maybe a little smaller, maybe a little bigger, give or take an inch. But I don't know if you can see this, but I'm using my Matsuo outside shad crankbait. It's pretty nice. My first time using crankbaits again. Temperature's 50. Water temp's probably 55-60. It's a pretty nice bass for crankbaits in this pond. He's pretty fat. I think he's 3 pounds. Probably 3 pounds. So, throw this guy back. Probably revive him since it's colder. Alright, come on. He's been out of the water for a while. Are you ready now? Are you already ready? There you go. There you go, bud. Hey guys, it's the Ohio Fisherman. I'm still casting around crankbaits, still 60 degrees, I mean 50 degrees, water's probably 55 still. I'm just casting over there, probably the third hit, like that third crank, I got a nice hit. Still using this, Matsuo crankbait. And I caught this probably 13-inch, give or take 2 inches. I mean, 15, give or take an inch bass. Pretty nice fish. Hit, like, almost on top of the water when I was... Alright, guys. I'm fishing with my friend Michael Whitacre at one of my friend's pond. It's pretty big, as you can see right here. Pretty big pond. There's another side over there. He took a warm-up cast, and he caught this hog. One cast on a Senko, like, green worm. What was it, like, Texas rig?
It was a weightless Texas rig on a Yamamoto Senko with a 4-aught Gamagatsu hook.
And look at that hog right there.
First cast.
That's probably an 18-inch bass. He probably will.
This thing is about 4 pounds.
Yeah. Right now, it's probably 40.
Hey, I got a measuring tape in my backpack. Want to get it?
Oh, yeah. Which bucket?
Back pocket.
It's like 40 degrees right now. Here we go. It was raining, windy, so...
We gotta get this thing warm.
Yeah. Alright, you guys, he is around 17 inches. I don't know if you can see that right there, but it says 17. That's a nice fish right there, man.
Yep, okay, put him back.
Yeah, put him back.
Careful,
quick. Oh my god, first cast. You gonna revive him? There you go. You're not like Sammy, my cousin. Oh my gosh. Alright guys, we're fishing at Ellsworth Golf Course. You've seen it in like 2 videos probably, maybe 3. And we're fishing the same stuff we're using the other day. This is pretty close. There's a nice 14-inch probably.
Pound and a half probably.
Yeah. Caught him cast right along the shore. Water's up on this since it rained a little. Michael missed one, I took a cast, and I hooked him. So, yeah, that's not bad. I'll show you. I'm using a June bug colored worm. It's like a wacky worm, but I just Texas rigged it, so yeah.
I'm using a little, I'm using a little Senko too. It's a got a chartreuse tip, but he caught that one, and I missed mine, so that one's probably better.
No, the eyes aren't yellow anymore, but yeah, I'm going to throw them back.
Okay. Hey, how do I stop the video?
Alright guys, we are, set up. We are, fishing at Ellsworth Golf Course again with the Texas rig worms on they're weightless, they're Texas rig weighted. And double headers, right there. Mine's my little one right there, female, caught him on a June bug. And his big one, probably, 13 inches, give or take an inch. Mine's probably 10 or 12. He's a chunky.
You get a belly on that thing.
Yeah, nice belly. Mine's just a little dink.
Thank you. Okay.
Put them both back.
Yes,
mine's female, his is a male.
So they're going to be sexing. Okay. Sorry, that was weird.
Yeah, it was weird. Just put him back. Don't throw him.
Well, that was a little one. Doesn't
yeah,
matter.
Just look.
There. How about go. Fish?
Hey guys, Seahawk Fisherman again. Test this rig. Weightless.
How's casting by that tree right there?
Right when I hit under it, my line took off and this little thing hit it. Probably 12 and 11 inch fish. Nice, but still, it's probably 40 degrees, maybe 45. Water is 45. It's windy. It just stopped raining. I'm freezing, my hands at least. So.
Wear gloves. You're smart if you wear gloves.
Yeah, it's a nice little bass. Shimano Corrado Baitcaster. Medium heavy at St. Croix. 7-foot graphite rod, 2-aught wide gap hook from Gamagatsu hook, and then carry it. So yeah, it's nice.
Don't fall, bud.
There you go.
Alright, we're fishing at Ellsworth Golf Course in Hudson, Ohio. Really chilly out here. It's on Texas rigs. Eric Michael's really, really thick bass.
Pretty thick.
He hit one or twice.
Twice. And now third.
I got Delta right in the middle. There's a creek right there that comes out. There's a Delta. He casted right on the top of the Delta, and that thing just came out and hit it.
Yep. And I'm using a Texas rig weightless Gary Yamamoto Senko with a 4-aught Gamagatsu hook on my 6'6" lightning rod pole from Berkeley and a Abu Garcia Silver Max.
Alright, put that boy back.
Okay. See ya, man.
Hey guys, the Ohio Fisherman. Now, we've made our way a lot farther. I have big fish that we caught, and the camera wasn't working too good, so we didn't really get that, but we might have gotten it on the other phone. Mm-hmm. So, we threw it in a creek right there, and he got that, and I saw a spot that's a little bit smaller than what I caught, but still. Mine was beefier.
Actually, mine's got a bigger belly.
They're about the same, but it's a really nice one. We're still using the same Texas rigs. We'll make a video to show you how we're working those on our next time around, so. Yeah, it's a nice fish. Come back.
Yep, okay. I'm going to go put him back where I got him.
This is where we got him at, right here.
All good.
Guys, the fishing. We switched ponds. We're at one out. I've fished once before and only caught one fish at. We've had three fish in three casts today, and this one, we had one back there. I had technical camera difficulties, so. And here's, since we caught this hog, it actually worked. He said he's 18 inches.
Look how thick this thing is.
He's really thick. He's pretty.
Yeah.
Huge mouth.
Very nice color.
Michael caught him on a Senko Texas rigged worm.
Yeah.
Like this.
I changed colors because I ran out.
Yeah.
Watermelon with red fleck.
There's just bass all over here. Just release them good. Don't throw them.
Yeah,
I'm not gonna throw them. And he's gone.
Hey guys, this is Michael. I'm with Ohio Fisherman right now. And Alex just caught this nice hog.
Right after you caught your big hog that we got on a video.
Yep. And so, in this pond right here, we've caught about five fish that are all about this size. And this is a little bit bigger than the ones we were normally catching. It's about the same size as the one I just caught, so.
Three pounds.
It's nice. Yeah, 3 pounds. Okay, let's let him go.
Oh, this pond's cold.
Hey, this is my largemouth that I just caught in this pond right here that we're fishing at Ellsworth Meadows Golf Course. And I'm guessing it's like maybe 19, 20 inches long. It weighs roughly 5 pounds, and it's pretty nice.
Caught him on a pipe over there.
Yeah. I caught him off the pipe. It was a little bit deeper than that. And so, yeah. So, let's go. Really quick. Right here.
Jeez.
And
guys, you know, fishermen. We went to this little pond over here, and we're still throwing the Senkos. And, yeah, that ate my Senko. That big, huge green sunfish. Green sunfish, not a bluegill, a green sunfish. Yeah, you can tell the difference because their mouths are bigger, they're more aggressive. And Yeah, come back.
Whee!